Carlton Cinema is set in the heart of Westgate-on-Sea and is now one of the oldest cinemas in the South East. This year, the Carlton will be celebrating its centurion birthday as a cinema. This cinema has a growing cult following that visits on a regular basis due to the friendly staff and welcoming atmosphere.
We took it on, it's almost 2 years to the day pretty much, end of November 2009. We reopened 18th of December. And we've been open for 2 years on the 18th of December as an independent, but the cinema's been running for 100 years.
So, will the Carlton Cinema still be around for another 100 years, or will the independent cinema cease to exist? With the number of multiplex cinemas on the rise, we asked the Carlton staff what they thought the benefits were owning and running their own independent cinema.
Meeting the customers, seeing customers come through the door, and having a chat with them when they come out about the film. And with a multiplex, you don't get that because you see loads of customers come out at once and don't know what film they've seen, and so that's what's nice about it, is that it's a small intimate cinema.
The benefits for viewing public, you get a personal service, you get a hello, you get a smile, you get the staff showing you to your seat, you don't get called like a number, you don't queue in a very clinical environment. Generally it's just a more intimate experience, much more intimate experience.
I think whatever you do it as you would like it done, and everyone's different, so, you know, we do it our way.
We asked the general public, what makes you come here rather than a multiplex cinema such as The View?
Because it's local, I can walk around the corner from home.
I think it helps with the community, really.
Reminds me of when I was courting. Am I allowed to say that?
I like it better, it's more comfortable. I don't like the view up Westwood Cross.
The seating, the kind of ambience.
We sort of listen to what the community wants as much as we can. I mean, it's not easy, and it's a big ship that takes a long time to sort of drag round to where you want it to go. But we do a lot of Facebook stuff, sort of speaking to our customers, a lot of sort of, you know, interaction here is what we want. Events, stuff like that, just stuff to get people interested. And to sort of make it their own, really, and to contribute. And that's the way forward, I think, is to get people or customers that enjoy it to contribute to it and make it their own.
So how long have you been working here?
About a year, just over a year.
Okay. And what are the benefits of working side by side with the Carlton?
Well, we have a crossover with people who want to go to a good movie and have a decent cup of coffee and perhaps come out afterwards and socialise and chat about the movie. So. I see no disadvantages.
Frederick's is a sister business to the Carlton Cinema, which draws in coffee lovers and also cinema lovers who want to grab a hot drink either before or after their film. Charlotte and Joanna, who both go in the Carlton and Frederick's, who add a personal touch by baking cakes to ensure a brilliant homemade standard, and some cakes are gluten-free, so they're available for everyone. Frederick's has been a large part in the revival of the Carlton and is a brilliant moneymaker for the business. And it's not the only thing that Carlton has done to ensure profit.
We've run several events now, with a zombie film, getting dressed up. I think, you know, we all like to get dressed up here, so that's what we've been doing. And we've done some extra kids shows and things like that. I mean, we aren't the most experienced cinema owners. So we've been doing stuff that, you know, staff have suggested, customers have suggested. And it's worked. And charity stuff, to raise money for charity and things like that. Stuff that's sort of very sort of community-based, really.
Various clubs and special events help to continually draw in new crowds. Competitive prices and a selection of delicious confectionery help to keep their faithful followers entertained.
We've put on several events which has got our name out into the community, and people have supported us, and hopefully in the future they will support us even more. And we've got events planned for next year.
Of course, it's not all easy going in running your own cinema. Competition from other cinemas in the area, coupled with the increased shadow approaching of the multiplex, has been something that the Carlton has to begrudgingly deal with.
We don't think about the multiplex, but it's there, and it does take most of the custom. They can run films almost back to back. Home video technology today, people don't go out so much to watch film in a cinema. We're competing against that.
Indeed, the effect of home video has been a massive blow to cinemas around the world, and has prompted a large rethink of how cinemas, especially independent, apply to the masses.
We've made plans for digital. We're looking at digital. We've got to. So that's a new experience. That will be a new experience.
Digital cinema has many advantages, including easy storage and many new possibilities. But many projectionists and cinema critics consider digital to be lazy. We headed over to the Granville Cinema to speak to the projectionist and manager about his routine and how he thinks the change will affect the industry and, more importantly, the people involved in it.
Once the digital projector goes in, it's about that big, so you wouldn't have that, a bit more room. And no film, very quiet, quite boring really, nothing to look at. But obviously a picture quality is about the same. To fit digital you have to have a brighter means of illumination. And you have to have usually have to have a new screen with a silver coating rather than the white plastic that we have, so that it reflects the light and maximise the amount of brightness. So fitting digital is not cheap.
Projectors at the Carlton at Westgate, they are a much younger kind of style of projector. This is like a tank here. I'd say these are about 50 years old.
Whether you like digital cinema or not, it is coming, and like sound and colour before it, digital plans on staying. The Carlton, like many others, has been quick to pick up digital and will soon have it installed. It is just one of the many things they have to deal with.
A different atmosphere now. That's what's hard about it, to keep it going. And also advertising is hard, getting the word out that we're open and we are running, flourishing, trying to. Advertising, we have a brand new website. Facebook, we've got a lot of followers on Facebook, and we do a lot of leafleting and word of mouth. And we still, after 2 years, have some people come and say they didn't realise that we were still open. So it's a long, hard walk uphill still. But that's it in a nutshell. 2 years, it's been a learning curve in how to run the cinema, film booking, etc., staffing. Dealing with the public, who've been really good. They have been supportive. We've had a few hiccups. It's been good. It's been interesting.